Hey everyone, it's Alyssa. Today I'm going to be doing a what I eat in a day quarantine edition. Honestly guys, I've found the most healthy, sustainable, and happy eating routine while in quarantine. I think it was because I was eating so much and kind of bad in the beginning of quarantine that now I've just really leveled out in a good way. I got my morning coffee, which I've been having every single morning just because I've been having problems sleeping and I've been going to bed at like 4 or 5 in the morning. So I wake up kind of groggy. Sorry if I'm not in the most energetic mood right now. It's just some like dark roast Pete's coffee with almond milk and stevia. Okay, so I'm gonna show you guys breakfast because I'm starving. I'm going to be making these protein like oat pancakes. And I've been making these a lot recently. They're super, super good. Let's go make them. I'm so excited. I'm using the Simple Truth plant-based protein powder. It's not my favorite. My favorite's the Fit with Cambry protein powder, but I ran out of that. I love oats. You guys aren't surprised how much cinnamon I'm putting in here. Okay, so I put my hair up because I was getting really hot. Also guys, I'm like dying excited to show you this, but while the pan is heating up, I have this amazing berry sauce that I like to put on these pancakes that's to die for, and it has no added sugar and it's not bad for you. It tastes like you're eating the funnel cake sauce at a fair, but you're not. You're gonna be shocked to see that there's like no ingredients besides the berries, pretty much. But it's absolutely amazing. I try to cook with like no added sugar and like no added salts, and I'm just kind of like a healthy baker and healthy cook. Sorry for the bad lighting, but what you're gonna need for the berry sauce is just a little pot. Some frozen berries of your choice. I'm using blueberries and strawberries. I'm just putting in like a handful of each. Next, we're gonna add a little bit of water. Also, I'm gonna be adding a little bit of chia seeds. I'm making like this berry, chia, strawberry compote. That might have been too much, but whatever. So here's breakfast. I think it looks absolutely stunning. And I've been making this quite a bit for the past few weeks. Bon appetit. Hello everybody. So I look really gross and sweaty right now, but that's okay. That sweat means that we worked hard. I just ran a mile and then I did some body weight workout. It's kind of the same thing I've been doing this whole quarantine. I prefer to do 1 mile timed HIIT workouts rather than long distance steadily paced. It sounds kind of weird, but I like the pain of making yourself run really fast. And if you're wondering, I'm on the side of my house. It's a change of scenery. Let's go inside and make some lunch. The sun feels so good. I apologize if you can hear the dishwasher in the back. It's currently running. So for lunch, we're gonna be making this blended juice kind of smoothie thing I've been making lately, some chicken and veggies. And please, please don't come at me for this blended juice that I'm making. I know it's gonna sound kind of gross, and I'm not telling you to drink it, but I drink it. So I start off with ice. Then to this, I'm gonna add some frozen strawberries. I'm gonna add some broccoli. And let me just sit you down so I can tell you why. Normally, I would put kale and spinach in this, but I ran out. So lately I've been putting broccoli in this like juice thing, and it's actually not bad, guys. I've been like immune basically to healthy things that probably taste bad to everybody else. But on the bright side, adding frozen broccoli makes it thicker. And in addition to this, I'm adding some greens powder. You guys know I use this like all the time. Gives you energy and stuff, which I need because I'm gonna be doing homework all day. Let's not forget, I'm still in school. And now, another roughing it ingredient. I'm gonna use half of a peeled lime because I'm out of lemon. And now, for probably an ingredient grosser than the broccoli, I'm adding a tablespoon of apple cider vinegar. Adding apple cider vinegar drastically changes the taste. Like drastically. Just because I'm already making this like a health just jungle drink, I add my woman's one a day multivitamin and also some vitamin C because we all need vitamin C during the pandemic. And then I just fill this up with water. If you hear sizzling in the background, that's because I'm cooking the chicken. So this is not an appealing color at all. I just got hit by like a wave of tiredness for some reason. I finished cooking my lunch, so I have sweet potato and some chicken. I'm just gonna do some homework now, and I'll probably be doing homework for like the next 5 hours. If you're wondering what it is, it's Calc 3. Everyone, it is dinner time. So as you guys saw me making, my mom went to my family's favorite pho restaurant and I got a child size vegan pho, which is my favorite one. Obviously I'm not vegan, but like that one's just the one I was in the mood for today. And I took it upstairs because I'm still doing homework. As you can see, studying and then eating my pho. It just has some glass noodles, some vegetable broth, tofu, onions, mushrooms, all that good stuff. Sorry that I'm looking kind of rough right now. I took a shower and I've been just doing homework all day. And you know, that quarantine cabin fever puts your brain in a certain kind of mood, you know? You guys know what I'm talking about. We're all kind of depressed. Anyways, so that concludes this what I eat in a day video. I definitely want to do more like this in the future, just make it a regular thing to do random what I ate today or like full day of eating, because I think those are really fun. I think they're really cool to watch and to make. So thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye everyone.